took a trip, now we on your block, and it's like a ghost town. Baby, where did these be at when they said they doing all this and all that? Tired of beefing you bums, you can't even pay me enough to react. Been waking up in the crib, and sometimes I don't even know where I'm at. Please don't pay that songs in this party, I can't even listen to it.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. You're back at it again with me, Daniela. Hope all is well, hope all is calm. I literally figured that like I was already dolled up, so why not make a YouTube video for you guys? Actually, I'm not gonna lie, I filmed this before, but I don't think you guys care about what happened to that video, so whatever. We move on. If you guys are new to my YouTube channel, please make sure you guys like, comment, or subscribe. Do the damn thing. Especially if you guys like my content, I don't see why you wouldn't subscribe. Do your girl a favor. We are on road to like 1,000 subscribers. We are on road to monetization. So yes, thank you guys so much for tuning into my channel today, tuning into my video, whatever. As you guys can see from the title, this video I'm going to be talking about my weight loss journey. A lot of people messaged me asking me questions, what I did, you know, apple cider vinegar, did it work, my workout routines, etc. And I just thought I should come on here and be super transparent with you guys and just kind of like talk to you guys and let you know that I didn't go on any sort of like crazy diet. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I still ate fast food. Like, I did. Like, I feel like when you want to lose weight, like, you in your head you feel as if it's like something that needs to be done like tomorrow, as in you work out and you go step on the scales and you're gonna be like, why haven't I dropped any weight? I feel like when you want to lose weight, the first thing that you have to do is change your mindset first. Like, you have to understand that it is a process. A lot of people do have different bodies. We have to understand that some people lose weight by doing nothing, some people gain weight by doing nothing. Like, people's bodies are different. Like, my sister and I, like, her current weight, when I weighed what she currently weighs, I look nothing like how she currently looks. Like, if anything, I look double her size. But that's just how my body is built. But yes, like I was saying, when you want to lose weight, the first thing you should do is literally change your mindset. You know, is it a temporary thing? Am I just losing weight for an occasion? Or do I actually want to change my lifestyle and start eating cleaner? I genuinely want to start exercising so that I can just live a fit, healthier life. One thing I understood was a diet kind of seems temporary, so I don't like saying I'm on a diet because it just kind of sounds as if I'm just kind of eating less and kind of eating clean for an upcoming occasion. But when I say a change of lifestyle, it genuinely means that this is something for the long term. This is something that I want to do for good. I genuinely want to eat healthier. I genuinely want to eat cleaner for a long time. So that is definitely what I say. Yes, I'm changing my lifestyle. Basically, so what I did was, I actually wanted to lose weight a long time ago, but it genuinely kicked in the month of August. I said I was going to lose 10 kgs in the month of August. I did not lose 10 kgs in 1 month. I lost about 5 kgs in a month, and how I did that was, I practiced intermittent fasting. So I would eat between the hours of 2 or 6 o'clock. But in saying that, guys, I'm not going to lie to you guys, I was snacking after 6 o'clock because I got hungry. So I would snack. I'd probably have like a biscuit. I'd probably have an apple. I'd take a bite out of somebody's food. And before bed, I would always drink apple cider vinegar as well as green tea. So with apple cider vinegar, I'll probably have about 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar with about a quarter of a cup of water, and I'll just kind of scull that down. I would literally block my nose so that I'm not smelling it, and I'll just scull it down and chase it down with water. And then after that, I would drink green tea. I found apple cider vinegar and green tea to be very effective in the morning, at the start of my day, as opposed to nighttime. I don't know why that is. In the morning, I would feel fuller, so it will last me up until like 2 o'clock when I would eat. When I do eat, I'm feeling super full, and it would wash me out. It would wash me out as well. Like, when I would have apple cider vinegar and green tea, I'm like running to the bathroom, and then when I'm eating, I'm just kind of like eating, and then I'll just kind of occasionally kind of then I'd kind of like go to the bathroom a little bit at times throughout the day because of whatever it's doing in my system. I don't know what, but yeah, I found it to be very effective in the morning, but I would still drink it at night time just because I love green tea. And I think I still drank it at night time just to see what it would do to my weight overnight. Will I burn more calories? Which I found So it really depended on the day. Sometimes I would wake up and be like a kg lighter. Sometimes I'd wake up and I haven't burnt any calories. I'm still weighing the same. But one thing I learned is to not depend on the scales too much, because I would see the scales not moving, but physically I can see that I'm losing weight. And you have to understand that there is something called water weight. Your body weight also fluctuates. I don't even know if that makes sense, but what I did was, I would eat fast food, guys. I'm not even gonna lie to you guys. I wouldn't eat it every day, because I came from a point of eating fast food like 8 times a week. Literally, like, I would have fast food like at least once a day, at most like 2 or 3 times a day. I was drinking Coke. I would have like a large Coke to start my day, to keep me up, to get me full. And I wasn't gaining weight, and this was during quarantine, post-quarantine. Then literally like from like May, June, my weight just went boom. Like, I gained about 12 kgs in the last couple of months. I gained like 12 kgs. Like on average, I want to weigh between 60 and 65 kgs. I'm currently weighing 78 kgs from about 83. I've always been about 70, 69, 68. That's always been my average weight. And, you know, even when I was weighing that, I always thought I was fat. But now that I am fat, I'm actually like, sis. I'm really working my butt off to get back to my average weight. And then from there, just kind of lose a bit more weight and maintain it. So, yeah, I cut off fast food. I cut off soft drinks. I exercised a lot. Like, I'm not a heavy, like, all my days I'm at the gym, I'm carrying weights. I don't know how to do that. I just do a lot of cardio. I did a lot of walking. I would aim to do at least 10,000 steps a day. I'll be on the tread for it, no, like, minimum 30 minutes. Then I'll do some squats, I'll do some core workouts, I'll do a bit of weights, and then I'll leave. I'll be at the gym for like maybe like an hour to an hour and a half, but keep in mind, like, that hour is literally, first hour is achieved me doing cardio, the other half an hour I'm really watching I'm really looking at other people. But when the gyms are closed, I was going on 5k walks, and I'd come home, do some more cardio. That's what I did. But in saying that, I don't want to like discourage anyone to feel like they can't eat fast food. Like, obviously there is a balance to everything. Like, you have to understand, gaining weight is when your body is consuming more calories than you're burning off. So for me, if I knew that, I don't know, like, I'm gonna have like a Big Mac meal, like, the average woman calorie intake of a woman, I believe, is 2,000 calories. And for example, I don't know what a Big Mac, the calorie intake is, but I'll put it somewhere on the screen. If it's less than 2,000, I'm fine, and I'm exercising, I've basically burnt off what I've eaten, like, I'm fine. But if I go have a Big Mac meal, I go have another pizza, I have some Coke, I do all of this, I haven't worked out, obviously I'm gonna gain weight. So I'm just here to tell you guys, don't be too hard on yourself. Like, exercise, it's a balance, like, you know, like, don't deprive your body. Like, just, you know, like, that's one thing I learned. I would always punish myself and starve myself, but then I got comfortable. I was like, look, at the end of the day, I'm exercising, I'm going to the gym, like, I'm burning off what I'm eating. Like, but I didn't make a habit out of it. I wasn't eating McDonald's every day. If it was there, I would eat it, but I wouldn't go out of my way to go and buy it. If I was with the girls and we're craving something, I was like, you know what, I've been good this whole week, let me go and have Macca's. But I'd get like a cheeseburger. I stopped drinking Coke completely, so every time I was eating fast food, I was always having it with water, drinking a lot of green tea. Green tea is so good for you. The benefits, I don't know them off the top of my head, but I know that there are such amazing benefits for you. I love green tea. Like, when I'd go to Starbucks, I would have like a green tea, an ice shaken green tea, a green tea frappuccino, anything green tea, I am there. I used to hate green tea. Apple cider vinegar, it tastes disgusting, but eventually you gotta do what you got to do. You've got to do what you've got to do. But I found that it really, really worked. And yeah, like, this is just a quick video of what I did to lose a bit of weight. It is a journey, it is a process, you know. At the end of the day, don't be too hard on yourself. I didn't want to come in here and lie to you guys and tell you guys that I was eating lettuce and tomatoes every single day, because that was not the case at all. I am nowhere near my goal. If anything, I want to lose literally like another 8 kgs until I'm back at my average weight, and then from there start losing a bit more. It just cutting and maintaining the weight. I'm not going to be happy until I hit 65 kgs, but I have not put a time. I do not have like a time set to achieve this just because I want to just be patient with myself. I just kind of want to let my body do what it's got, like it's doing, like continue exercising, continue eating healthy, and whatever my body drops. Like, because it's a lifestyle change for me, I'm seeing it as a, as long as I'm eating good, as long as I'm drinking my water and exercising, whatever my body decides to lose, it will lose, and naturally it will lose weight because I'm eating clean. But yes, if you guys want to see more weight loss videos, like, you know, following my journey, let me know in the comments down below. And I did record a what I eat in a day video, like it's 1 month old, I should probably upload it. I think I'll do that for you guys. And yeah guys, the thumbnail is a mess, my nails, absolute mess. But yeah, I will definitely drop more videos in regards to my weight loss journey to kind of keep you guys updated, so you guys can kind of go on this journey with me as well. And yeah, thank you guys so much, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. Line me out where it's warm, I said frio. And you can hit it like Jose, but give you this heat, Caliente. But I'ma need a big sweet residente.